সাগাড়ি বাগি কবক নাই তাকু মধুসূদন দেববর্মা রাংসা পরিচক ফাউন্ডেশন নি
বরম গনাং নারওয়াই রত্ন আং কিসা বিসাং ফাইলানি বাগি কবহ জং চিনি জাতি ক ধর্ম সুমানি বিসুতি চিনি তিনি নি পান্ডাল চেঙ্গি রলাই না
স্টপ কুসুম কুসুম বাগি চিরাং জাতি সঙ্গে নাম সত্যি বাগি ও জাতি বহ অন্য খারো সিনিয়া কাকসা সম্পন নকবার বলে বাকসা খুবনি বাহাই বলে বাকসা নকি আকৃতি বলে বাকসা তুইমানি উমর বলে বাকসা তে তুইমি মা চুবাখা বেড়েগা হামবাই রক্ষা করে দে চিনি লক্ষ্য তাম মানে বাকি অজরাও বেড়ে নয় শুশু ডাকু তাবু মে অপেচিব ল্যাপসক মানে ক নারেকানি বাকি খাবাই তাবক নাই রাংসা বৃক্ষাক ফাউন্ডেশনই টাংখাং অগ্রা বড় গ্রাম মোচাং সজো দেবর্মা স্যার প্লিজ স্যার
খোলো বঙ্গিয়া ফার দাংসা ওয়াচুক যাক তিনি নি ও রাংসা বৃক্ষা সকাত নি নারায় অগ্রা মহারাজ কুমারী প্রজ্ঞা দেববর্মন নারায় বরম মান
I'd like to congratulate all the awardees for their contributions to our state and to the country also, of course. And what I'd like to say, I don't want to speak very much, I apologize, because, you know, I think we've spoken enough about everybody and how we have come upon the awardees and how we have chosen the names and why such awards should be given to each person. We've heard a lot of history, so we'll not go into that. I'll just say a few words, and let's take our state, Tripura, as it is today. We know we have talent, we know we have people who have contributed to society in their own way, culturally, historically, through different art forms as well. But this has been going on not now, but for hundreds of years. How come Tripura, out of all the northeastern states, has been able to survive despite a lot of problems that we've had here. We need to think, how is it that we are still around and we are still going ahead and hopefully doing better? It's because we moved with time. Time is an important factor. The world is dynamic. If we are not dynamic, if we don't move with the times, the state will be over, our inspirations will be over, and that is the end of history and culture. You see, the Ahom kingdom, they were famous at one time. During that period, there were Tripura Buranjis that are chronicled, some historical books that were written at the time of Rudra Sagar, Ahom king, who sent his emissaries, people to Tripura at that time to write the history, not only with wealth, but with literature. And there were people coming from different parts of the world, not just India. And if you read history, you'll find out, yes, that we had foreigners coming from different lands, Greeks, French, others, into Tripura. Why did they come? And other parts of India as well. They came to Tripura because we had such a good culture of absorbing and helping out anyone who was interested in education, language, craft, art, music, paintings, and even later on photography. A lot of people don't know, I think we need to also have an award on that. Maharaja Bir Chandra Manikya was the first person, a pioneer, who introduced photography into Eastern India by starting his own studio in the palace. There were only two people at that time, Deen Dayal, mainland India, and in Tripura or in Eastern India, it was Maharaja Bir Chandra. With limited funds, those days, life was not easy. Despite that, he took it up to educate his children, his wife, princesses, all of them in photography. He was also a poet, not many people know that. He was an artist. I'm not saying that, you know, he was a Maharaja, so maybe he had the time. No, they had more work to do at those days. There was no Delhi government to send you funds for development of a state. You had to do everything with your own pocket. Despite that, to take out time to teach others and to promote art, culture, science. He was also an astronomer. In those days when things were so difficult, they did that. One person I know who's a writer from Manipur, he told me, in Manipur we don't have anything. Tripura has everything. You all have paintings, you have music, you have monuments. Manipur, we don't have anything which is older than 150 years. Why is it like that? I started thinking. I said, yes, it's a fact. In other parts of northeastern India, we don't have that rich culture and heritage like they don't have like us, except for a few states. If we did not preserve all that, down the centuries, we would have lost that. Because it was preserved, we are still going on. And now too, with foundations like the one we are talking right now, Rangchak Richak Foundation, and maybe there are many other foundations. I also work for an organization called INTACT, Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage. I'm the convener in charge of Tripura. So for many years, I have also seen their difficulties, but we still try to preserve what is left of Tripura. And if we don't do that, we'll become like the other states where everything will be gone. Then it will be too late to start everything from scratch. So I encourage such foundations to come forward, and I encourage all of you, there are a lot of people who are quiet, hidden talents are there, to get some encouragement from our people here who are doing so much despite not having all the facilities. Hearing some of the poems that were being said here, I said, I write poetry also, not many people know. I won an award in America, International Poetry Award, some years ago. And I feel some feelings, then only I can write. So normally I do my other written work on culture, history of Tripura and other things. I used to make films also. Come on. So I used to write documentaries. It reminds me when I was in school also, I was very active. I used to write drama, for which I got a certificate as a child. So I'm not a very talkative person. I don't go out much. I spend a lot of time in Tripura, coming and going, developing my work. Many of you know I have this old building, Chandra Mahal, which I have restored. It is over 130, 140 years old. It took a lot of time. Recently, I even restored the top portion. So I take up a lot of my time trying to do things for the architecture also of the state. So basically what I'd like to say is, we've come here for this function and we've awarded all our noble people here. And I want all of us to come together. We may be from different backgrounds, but if you want to preserve and promote Tripura's history and culture, art, literature, language, music, there's so much. We can only do it unitedly. If we lose all that today, there will be no future. Like I said, people in other states like Assam, they've lost what they have. Our homes are no longer there. Thai culture is over. Manipur is regretful about whatever's happened. They're trying to revive. The other states are there, but there's no really a good example of a state that has thrived in the Northeast like Tripura. So let us build Tripura. Let us all come together, join hands, irrespective of our backgrounds, and do our best. That's all I'd like to say. Thank you very much.